Okay, so to start our RE lesson today, I'd like to recap all the things that we've learned about the Lord's Prayer so far. So we've learned about a couple of parts of the Lord's Prayer. What do you remember about what we've learned so far? Can you remember any of the lines from the Lord's Prayer that we talked about? Can you remember what they mean? So far then, we've learned about Our Father. So it starts with Our Father who art in heaven. And when we talk about Our Father, we're talking about God. And then it says, give us this day our daily bread. Now, when we think about give us this day our daily bread, we're not just talking about bread. We're talking about things that we need and what God gives us to help us to survive. So that's what each of those parts of the Lord's Prayer mean. Today, we're going to see if we can understand how Christians consider how Jesus would behave. And we're going to think about the next part of the Lord's Prayer and think about how that relates to people's lives and what they would do. So to be successful, we're going to see if we can remember parts of the Lord's Prayer. We're going to see if we can understand what temptation is. We're going to see if we can explain what Christians believe about temptation. And we're going to see if we can understand how to focus on what we want to achieve. So that word tempting or temptation you may have heard before or you may not have heard before. If you're tempted by something, it means that you think, I think I'm going to have a go at doing that. And normally it's something that you shouldn't do. So you're tempted to do it, even though you know full well that you shouldn't do that thing. So I know sometimes I think I'm tempted. I quite often get tempted to maybe order a takeaway instead of doing the cooking. Something I should do is do the cooking because I've already got that food in the fridge. It costs less money. It's probably healthier. But it's very tempting when you're tired to think, oh, I'll just order a takeaway because it's easier. So I sometimes give in to that temptation. I'm sure sometimes you're tempted to do things as well. Maybe you're tempted by really yummy food like chocolates and sweets and ice cream. Maybe sometimes you're tempted to copy someone's answers. If you don't understand something and you think, well, I don't want to look silly, maybe I'll just take a look at their answers. Is that a good thing to do? Well, not really, no, because you're not helping yourself to learn and to get better. And the teacher might think you do understand when you don't. So although it might be tempting to do that, it's probably not a good idea to do that. It can be very tempting, especially right now, as we're at home so much, to, you know, be on the computer at night time and not go to bed at a proper time. That can be very tempting because it can be quite fun to look at these things and to stay up late. But if you do that, it can end up being quite a bad thing for you, can't it? And in this one, if you've seen the film Pinocchio, you'll know that whenever Pinocchio tells a lie, his nose grows. So this picture represents lying. It can be very tempting to lie about something. Like if you know you've done something wrong and someone asks you about it, you might say, well, no, it wasn't me. But you know it really was you. And it can be tempting to lie so that you don't get into more trouble. But it normally turns out that when you do lie, it actually causes more trouble for everyone. So although lying can be quite tempting, it's another thing that we shouldn't really do. What Christians consider when they think about temptation is what would Jesus do? And some people wear a special band or a bracelet which has got these initials, WWJD, which stands for what would Jesus do? So I want you to have a think to yourself now. If there was temptation in front of Jesus, what do you think Jesus would do about it? Do you think that Jesus would succumb to that temptation? Or do you think maybe he would try and avoid that temptation? Now, as part of the Lord's Prayer, it says, lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. So in that part of the Lord's Prayer, it's saying that we should not be tempted by things. We should not let that temptation get the best of us. So Jesus would believe that we wouldn't want to be led into temptation and we'd want to avoid being tempted to do things that we shouldn't do. It can be very difficult. It can be a challenge for you, but it's something you should definitely try and do if you want to try and be like Jesus. Now, we're going to have a look at a video clip inside this video here. And it's all to do with some dogs. Now, these dogs have been specially trained to ignore distractions and temptations. So, you know, you can see the dog there. It looks really attentive and ready to go. And do you think that he will be able to ignore those distractions and temptations around him? Do you think that all of the dogs will be able to do that? When we finish the video, we're going to come back here and I'm going to ask you the questions at the bottom.
Left. Hey, mean? Istu.
Ja selkeästi Esmi saa heti vainun siitä, että lähellä on lenkkimakkaraa.
Noin. Hieno istu.
Upeasti Esme menee koko houkutusten highwayn. Ei epäröi.
So what did you think of that? Were you surprised at that about that last dog? I don't think that last dog was very good at avoiding the distractions and the temptations. Now, what can you learn about temptation from this video? What could you think that you could do? Is it difficult to avoid temptation? Do you need to train yourself like the dogs were trained? Because some of those dogs were very good at ignoring the temptation and just getting on with things. But I know that last dog in particular struggled with it. Are you more like those first dogs? Or are you more like that last dog? Which one would be the best dog to be like? Which one would be most Jesus-like? So as I said already, lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. What does that part of the Lord's Prayer actually mean? Well, it means that you're asking God to help Christians to stay away from bad things, not to do wrong, but rather do the right thing, to keep their eyes fixed ahead, fixed on God and the path that he wants them to take. So although that temptation is there, and you have that choice to take up the temptation, the Lord's Prayer teaches us that we should try to keep our eyes fixed ahead on the road ahead of us, and not to be veered away on the temptation path, because that will help us to deliver us from evil, to stop these bad things from happening to us. So to live a good life, Christians believe that they should not be tempted. And in the Bible, there are stories about Jesus and temptation, and Jesus didn't succumb to the temptation, and that way he could help deliver himself from evil. Now, for your task today, I've put the questions on DB Primary, but here they are. I'd like you to think about, for the first question, what are you tempted by? I want you to think about things that you find challenging and difficult to ignore and to try to be tempted by. What are you tempted by? It could be more than one thing. I'd like to write a sentence to explain about that. For question two, I want you to think about how does it feel to be tempted and why? For your third question, I want you to think about how you can avoid being tempted. So what could you do to try and stay away from that temptation, to stop that temptation from getting the best of us? Maybe you could give some advice about what you do when you try to avoid temptation. If you'd like an extension challenge today, it'd be really lovely to see some of you drawing your own poster to show you keeping your eyes on the road. Like we said, keeping your eyes on the right path to avoid temptation. When you've finished your work, don't forget to upload it to DB Primary so we can see it. And if you do need any help, don't forget you can send a message to us.